Hello everyone. Lastly, we have seen about the instrumentation guidelines and about the motions of instrumentation for particularly that is for cleaning and shaping. And basically, there are three techniques for cleaning and shaping, that is step back, crown down and hybrid. So starting off with the first technique, that is a step back technique. Now this is a very commonly asked long answer question, so you should know well about this step back technique, and even you should know this practically because now you do root canal treatments oftenly when you're going to the clinics. So step back technique is also known as a telescopic canal preparation, or it is also known as a serial root canal preparation. Now it is known as telescoping and serial root canal preparation just because now in this technique what you do is you serially prepare the root canal. Like for example, now you use a smaller instrument. Now about the endodontic instrument, I have covered in the video of endodontic instrument. So now we know that the endodontic instrument, they are available in various sizes. So it starts from a smaller size till a very large size. So smaller size instrument, they are thinner, and larger size instrument, they are thicker. So in this like step back technique, what we do is first we start with a thinner instrument, that is smaller size instrument, and then we go back to a larger size instrument. So because of that, it is a serial root canal preparation, that you are serially doing the preparation of the root canal. Now why it is known as a step back technique? Step back basically, now this is your root canal. So your root canal is divided into three parts, that is the coronal, middle and apical. Coronal as it is near to the crown, over here this is the middle, and apical as it is near to the apex of the tooth. So this is divided into three parts. Now basically in this step back, what you do is first to do the preparation for the apical third. Then you go towards the middle third, and then you go for the coronal third. Now in this, now you can see basically in crown down, what you do is first you prepare the coronal, then you do the middle, and then you do the apical third. So in that you're going in the downward direction. But now in this step back, what you do is you're going in the backward direction. Now over here, now you can see you're going in the opposite direction. So you're stepping back, that you prepare first apical and then you go back to the coronal, and hence it is known as step back technique. Now step back technique, in this the apical preparation is small and then it is gradually tapering. So over here first you start with the apical preparation, and the apical preparation is very small, and then you gradually taper it towards the coronal portion. So hence it is gradually tapering coronally. Now Klein, he was the first to describe a step preparation for a curved canal. Then Schelder, he was the one who suggested about this serial preparation, that you have to use different instruments. Then Wien, Martin, Walton and Mullet. So they were the people who advocated about this step back preparation. So Mullet, he was the one who described this step back technique into two phases. So that was the phase 1 and phase 2. So phase 1 is nothing but the apical preparation. So first, now we know in this step back, what you do is you do the apical preparation. So first you start with the apical. So that becomes your phase 1. Now in phase 2, it is the preparation of the remainder of the root canal, that is basically your middle portion and the coronal portion. And then there is a refining phase, that is 2A and 2B, in which you complete the preparation properly. Basically, it was introduced in the year 1969, and the studies, they were going on like for almost 5 years for this particular technique. So it is from year 1969 to 1974. So first we'll see about the main technique, because this is very important. So first we'll start with the phase one. In phase one, first you're going to evaluate the carious lesion. So in this, this is the carious lesion. So this is your carious tooth. Then next, you initially prepare the access cavity and you locate the canine orifices. So first, now we know we do the access preparation, and then we start with the cleaning and shaping. So in that, first you have done the access preparation, and then you're going to locate your orifices through which you're going to enter into your root canals. Then you're going to establish the working length. Now about the working length, I have already covered in the video of working length. So in the video of working length, we have seen that whenever we are determining the working length, we are keeping the working length 0.5 to 1 mm short of your apex. So this is like you have established the working length. Then next is you insert the first instrument, that is the smallest instrument. So you're using basically a 10 number K5. And then you do a watch winding motion. You are inserting it in the watch winding motion. Now about what this exactly watch winding motion is, I have explained all these motions in the video of instrumentation, like motions of instrumentation. So basically watch winding motion is moving the instrument back and forth, like clockwise, anti-clockwise. So first you insert your first instrument, that is the smallest instrument, that should be your 10 number K5, into the canal through this clockwise and anti-clockwise motion. The next step is, then you remove the first instrument that you have inserted, and then you irrigate the canal. Now you have to remember that whenever you are going to a newer instrument, you have to irrigate the canal very well, because now you are doing root canal treatment, so there are infection which is present in the pulp. So you have to irrigate the canal properly so that you can like go for your cleaning and chapel well. The next step is you have to place the next larger size file to the working length in the similar manner, and then you have to again irrigate. So first you have used a 10 number file, irrigated the canal. The next is you are going to place the next number file. So that is after 10, you get a 15 number file. So that is like you are inserting this 15 number file up to the working length. So you have determined your working length. So till the working length, you are inserting this 15 number file now. So you're going to move it in the rimming motion, and then again you're going to irrigate. So now the most important thing is you do not forget to recapitulate the canal with previous smaller number instrument. And recapitulate is nothing but you're going back to a smaller size instrument. Now we know like we are going to from a 10 number, we are going to a 15 number. And after 15 number, we'll go to a 20 number. So before going to 20 number, you go back to a smaller number file. So that is nothing but recapitulate. Now, why do you need to do this? So this is recapitulation. Now, for example, if suddenly you increase the number of the instrument, so you increase the size of the instrument, so there are chances like you don't know how wide your canal is. So if suddenly you increase an instrument, so there are chances that your instrument, it gets binded into the dentine, and there are chances that your instrument, it will break in the canal itself. What you do is then repeat the process. You need a size 25k file reaches the working length. So you're doing this process, like first you have done for your 10 number, then 15 number, then 20 number, and then you go for a 25 number K file. So you are going to insert this till 25 number K file till the working length. So now your working length, it was 0.5 to 2 mm short of your apex. So like for your 25 numbers, so the instrument like 10, 15, 20 and 25. So these four instruments, they are to be inserted till your working length. So this is the repeat the process till size 25k file, it reaches the working length, and again you have to recapitulate. So again and again you have to recapitulate, and you have to irrigate the canal properly. So that ends with the phase one. So in that, now you have done the apical preparation till the working length. Now you move on towards the middle third, and then you go for your coronal third. So now that starts with your phase two. So in this, now place the next file in the series to a length 1 mm short of the working length. Now we have inserted till 25 number. So after that, you insert a 30 number K file. So in that, what you have to do is, now you know your like working length, it was, for example, it was 20 mm. Now you have to insert a larger size. That means your 30K file till 19 mm. So this is nothing but you are placing a larger size file, then 25 number, 1 mm short of your working length. So now because of this, you will get that proper flaring and that step back technique. So now how you're going to insert the instrument? So it is through the watch winding motion, and you're going to remove the instrument by the circumferential filing. So circumferential filing is through the circumference of your canal. Now again, about this motions I have explained, and then again you're going to irrigate and recapitulate. So you have to like remember this, like after every step you have to do this irrigation and recapitulation. The next is, then you're going to repeat same procedure with successively larger instrument at 1 mm increments. So this is nothing but now you have inserted a 30k file. So after that you go for a 35k file. And then what you're going to do is, now you have stopped till 19 mm. Now when you insert at 35, you're going to stop at 18 mm. So that means you're successively larger file at 1 mm increment. And then again 40, you're going to stop at 17. Then 45, you're going to stop at 16 mm. So this is how you're going to do the preparation of your canal. So similarly, a mid canal and coronal part is prepared. So by this, now when you are going to increase the size of the instrument and you're going to stop 1 mm short of your working length, like 1 mm increments. So by that, you'll do that preparation of the middle portion and the coronal portion. So now over here in this diagram, now you can see this is a 30K file. So the blue one is your 30 number file. So the blue one, so 30 number file, it is 1 mm short of the working length. Then as you increase, so you go for 35, that is your green color one. So you are seeing now you're stopping this instrument at 2 mm short of your working length. After that, as you increase the size, then it is 3 mm short, then it is 4 mm short, then again it is 5 mm short. So this is how you do the canal preparation in the step back technique. You move from the apical then you move to the middle, and then you go for your coronal. By this, now this is serial. Now, why it is known as serial? Now you can like justify this answer, because you are doing the preparation in the serial manner, like you're increasing the size of instrument and you're doing, or you're making the coronal flaring of it. So finally, refining of the root canal is done by the master apical file by the pull and push motion. So that is your filing motion. So you're doing the refining of the root canal. So you have done the preparation of your canal properly with this step back technique. So basically, there are various variation in the step back techniques which can be like advocated. Basically, the step back technique is done with the help of hand instruments, but you can use gate Glidden's drill. Now I have explained what this gate Glidden drills are in the video of endodontic instrument. So you can use gate Glidden drills for the initial enlargement of the coronal portion, and you can use smaller Gates Glidden drill to prepare the mid root. So over here, this is a smaller and this one is a larger. So larger one is used for the coronal portion, and for the middle portion you're using a smaller one. And in this you can also use a headstrong file, that is H file, to flare the preparation. So these are the variations that are usually not done, but yes, they can be the variation for your step back technique. So now this is how your step back it looks like. So first, the apical portion is the thinner one, and then as and as you're increasing the size of the instrument, so obviously your instrument, they're getting thicker. So because of that, your preparation is also getting wider as and as you're increasing the size of the instrument. So this is how it looks. So this is the telescopic preparation of your root canal. So the step back preparation, it creates a small apical preparation with a larger instrument which I use successively, and then you decrease the length at the working length. So over here your working length, and after when you're using a 35, the working length is reduced over here, then for 40 it is here, then for 45 it is here, for 45 it is here. So like this, you're like reducing the working length and you're going for a larger instrument, and then you create this taper, so which is narrower in the apical portion and it is wider in the coronal portion. So this is nothing but a step back technique. Now what are the advantages? So it creates the smaller apical preparation, and the next is the taper, it can be altered by changing the interval between the consecutive instrument. So these are the advantages. Now what are the disadvantages? So the disadvantages is it is difficult to irrigate the apical region. Now for example, your canal is completely filled with some debris. So first, now in this step back, you go for the apical preparation. So if there is too much of debris, there can be difficulty to irrigate this apical region. Then it is time consuming. As you go for smaller, then you go for larger, and like this, you recapitulate, you irrigate. So because of that, it can be time consuming. Then there are more chances of pushing the debris periapically. Now first, we start with the apical third. So there are chances that you like apply the forces when you're doing this rimming motion. Now you know what exactly rimming motion is. So in rimming motion, you apply the forces apically. So because of that, there are chances that you can push the debris in the periapical region. Then it has tendency to straighten the curved canal. So when you're like pushing the instrument, so there are chances that you can straighten if the canals are curved. Then there are increased chances of the iatrogenic errors, that can be ledge formation, or it can be apical transportation, or it can be perforation. So there are chances of this iatrogenic errors more into this step back technique. Then there can be loss of the working length. Now as you are doing the flaring, so because of that flaring, there are chances that this working length, it can be lost. Then there can be difficulty to insert the instrument into canal if the canal it is blocked by any reason. So it is like difficult to instrument the canal properly. So these are the like many disadvantages that you will see for a step back technique. Now what are these errors, like endodontic errors? I'm going to make a video, different video, so you'll get a like complete idea of what this ledge formation is. So now in this diagram you can see ledge is nothing but basically your file is going out of your canal. So canal, it is basically over here. So you're going out of your canal. So this is nothing but ledge. And then next is apical. So you are pushing the like the debris into the periapical region. Then there can be perforation of your instrument in the periapical space. So this is nothing but like some of your iatrogenic errors when you're doing this step back technique. So to overcome these problems is like a modification of this step back technique, which is known as a passive step back technique. Now in this, it is an active one. So active is basically you're applying forces. So because of these forces, there are various errors which can occur. So to prevent that, what you do is you do this passive step back technique. Passive is nothing but without exerting the forces when you're doing the preparation. So passive step back technique, it was developed by Tora Beanjed So it involves the combination of hand and rotary instrument to attend the adequate coronal flaring before the apical root canal preparation. So what you do in this is passive is you get that proper flaring. Now in this we have seen like we do the flaring with the hand instruments only. So in this what you do is you can use hand and rotary instrument, that is your GG drills, that is your Gates Glidden drills, for the coronal flaring. So to flare your coronal portion you're using this GG drills. So because of this it is like a gradual enlargement of the root in the apical to coronal direction without applying forces. So you're not applying forces because you're using this instrument, and because of this it reduces that errors which you get in the normal step back technique. So how is the technique? So in this again you do the axis preparation, then you establish the working length, then you start with the number 15 file in the rimming motion. After that you go for your different files as we go for your step back technique. But in this you have to like remember that whenever you're inserting or whenever you're going towards the next instrument, a larger instrument, you are doing or you are inserting it in the passive motion. You are not applying any forces in this passive step back technique. So this, it removes the debris and it creates a mildly flared preparation for the insertion of your GG drills. Now as you're like widening the canal, so it becomes easy to like insert the GG drills into it. The next is you're doing the irrigation with the help of sodium hypochlorite. Then what you do is then you insert a number 2 GG drill which is inserted till the resistance is felt. So resistance is basically felt when your GG drill, it is binded into the canal. Then what you do is then you pull it back 1 to 1.5 mm and then you are activating, as it is a rotary instrument. So you are activating after you feel that binding or whenever you feel that resistance. And then what you do is then you move, you are activating this GG drills and then you move it in the up and downward direction. So this is basically you are flaring the mid portion. Then you go for the number 3 and the number 4 GG drills. So your number 3 and number 4 is basically same in the similar fashion as you're doing for your 2 number. Like whenever you feel that binding or whenever you're feeling that resistance, after that you go, like you pull your GG drill 1 to 1.5 mm above and then you activate your GG drills and then you move that GG drills into up and downward direction. So now, since the flaring and the removal of the curvature, it reduces the working length. So now this was a disadvantage which we have seen in the step back technique also. So now when you're removing the debris or when you're removing the curvature, there are chances that your working length, it will be lost. So to reconfirm the working length, what you're doing is again you are inserting a number 25 till the working length. So to like confirm that whatever working length we have got, so that remains the same. And then finally, after you have seen that you have confirmed about your working length, then again you start with the same technique that as you have done for your step back, in which you prepare the canal with sequential use of the progressively larger instrument. Like you use, so you have used a 20, then you go for 25, then you go for 30, 35, and you are reducing the working length by 1 mm as you are increasing the size of your instrument. So this is basically your passive step back technique, in which what you have done basically, so the basic difference between these two is you are using or you are flaring the coronal and the middle portion with the help of a rotary instrument, so that you do not have or you do not encounter the various errors which you see in the step back. As in step back you apply forces, so because of that forces there are chances that many errors can occur. So to prevent that, in this what you do without applying forces, you first do the flaring of your canal and then you do the preparation of your canal as same as of your step back technique. So basically you don't apply force in this step back, passive step back technique. So this was all about the step back technique, which is also known as telescopic, and the serial root canal preparation and the modification to it, which is known as a passive step back technique. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, then please like, comment. If you have any doubts, do share with your friends and do subscribe to my channel, as I'm going to cover the other two techniques also. So this was all about the step back technique. Thank you so much.